poor little Scott Morrison. He's now running around the country like a desperate man, trying to find something, anything, to scare the crap out of people about. He's got nothing else going for him now. His government's falling to bits, and his track record, well, it speaks for itself. Every problem is someone else's fault. Every crisis, someone else's responsibility. He's the guy who didn't hold a hose in the bushfires, forcing people to shake his hand. He didn't order enough vaccines in the pandemic, and he's got no plan for the future of our country. Climate change action is critical to our nation's long-term economic prosperity. We should be seizing the jobs that come from real action on climate change as the world decarbonises. Australia has the best renewable energy resources. And what's Scott Morrison got? Nothing. He's got a marketing pamphlet. No plan, no policies, no trajectory. He turned up internationally and embarrassed our country. We're now ranked last in the world. This is disgraceful. Now, I'm really excited about Labor's policy. 600,000 new jobs, lower power prices, and lower emissions. Right behind me here is Dandenong Station, the gateway to the Dandenong Manufacturing Precinct, one of the country's great manufacturing precincts. With Labor's plan, cheaper power prices, more investment in skills, we'll see new jobs created right around the country in places like this. What's Scott Morrison's response? Total lies. Before Labor's policy was even released, before he could have possibly read it, he was on TV saying, oh, well, power prices are going to go up and everyone's going to lose their job and there'll be no air conditioning and it'll be the end of the world. I mean, it's a desperate, desperate man. His backbench, of course, you know, they're out there singing his tune. There'll be no more barbecues. It'll be the end of the lawnmower, they tell us. You won't be able to order a steak. This is the guy before the last election who said electric vehicles were going to end the weekend. No Australian would be able to go camping anymore. You wouldn't be able to tow your trailer. Australians cannot believe anything that this Prime Minister says. Not a word that comes out of his mouth. It's just rorts and corruption and more lies. The modern Liberals, though, if there's anything more pathetic than the Prime Minister, it's these so-called modern Liberals who say one thing in their electorates but vote with Barnaby Joyce in Canberra. I mean, Katie Allen and Dave Sharma and Tim Wilson and Jason Falinski and Fiona Reid, they're terrified now that the independents are coming for them, demanding real action on climate change. I have to admit, I'll probably miss Fiona Reid and Dave Sharma. The Australian Financial Review, that great bastion of socialist thinking, you know, the right-wing economic press, even they have said there's only one party now in Australia with a realistic, ambitious plan for climate change, and that's Labor. Scott Morrison's given us $1 trillion of debt that generations will be asked to repay. At the election, Australians have a choice. We can choose a positive future with job creation or more of this corrupt, inept government.